Hi guys. Oh my god, my voice cracked there. Just give me a second. So, I just found the fanfiction. It has 4 parts. The name of this fanfiction is Heart of the Devil. I'm kind of sure if... what is really going on in this fanfiction? I think either you or Katsuki is a devil or something like that. And it's Katsuki Bako, ex-listener, so let me know if you guys want me to read the other parts. No further ado, let's begin. Heart of the Devil. Written by Mini Min on Wattpad, link in the description below. Author's point of view. Wayne Allen, the angel that everyone disliked. There wasn't really a good reason for doing so, they just did. Maybe it was because she was different, and they couldn't just accept the fact that absolutely everyone was different. Oh no. All the other angels in heaven believed that you had to be pure, had to be this pure, innocent angel that helped people and looked after the people on earth, protecting them from danger. But Wayne didn't want that. She didn't understand why and what was so wrong with being different. She shouldn't have to follow other people's orders just because they say so. You'll be able to be yourself no matter what. And that is what Wayne was doing. Being herself. But the other angels didn't like that at all. What made it worse was that she was about to find out something that her parents had been keeping from her for a long time. Something that was going to change her life forever. For better or worse. Wayne, the angel heard someone calling her name. Humming, she swiftly spun around to see her mother, fluttering over to her gracefully. Wayne's mother was a very respectful angel in heaven, along with Wayne's father. "Yes, mother?" Wayne asked, watching as her mother stopped flying in front of her. As her wings went down to her back once again, Wayne's mother bit her lip, looking fearfully. Fearful. Wayne immediately grabbed a hold of her mother's hand, sensing that something was wrong. "Mother, what is it?" she asked in a weird tone. "Me and your father have something to tell you. Now." Her mother shakily replied, fear and regret flashing through her eye-colored eyes. Wayne gulped but nodded. The angel couldn't recall doing anything wrong at all. Neither the less, Wayne followed her mother back to their house, where her father was patiently waiting to tell her the shocking news. Upon arriving, Wayne and the mother stopped flying and walked into the house, closing the door behind them. Wayne walked to where her father was at, looking equally as worried as her mother. Wayne raised an eyebrow in suspicion. "What is going on?" "Wayne, dear, sit," her mother pleaded, pushing Wayne closer. The angel just nodded and sat down on the floor, where her father was looking directly at him. Wayne's mother sat down next to the angel's dad and took her hand in his. Both of them squeezed their hands together for support. "When me and your mother have something important to tell you," her father said in a serious tone, making Wayne gulp. "What is it?" she asked, worried about what her parents were about to tell her. Her heart was beating fast, and her halo above her head was vanishing, then appearing once again. Something that happens when angels were nervous. "Well..." her mother began, averting her gaze to meet her partner's eyes, asking permission to carry the story on. "It is not." "You're not what you think," she finished off. "Huh? What do you mean?" Wayne asked, really confused now. Your father decided to explain further. You aren't an angel. Well, you are, but he was cut off by his daughter. What do you mean I'm not an angel, father? I'm pretty sure I am. I mean, I have a halo, wings, I can fly, heal people. Is that not an angel? Why am I gone, staring at your parents? No, Wen, please listen. Your father said, as to which Wen immediately went silent. Both her parents looked at each other before her father spoke up. You're an angel. Yes. It's quite obvious that you are one. He began, taking a deep breath, then began to talk once again. But there's something that me and your mother haven't told you yet. We were going to tell you a few years ago, but it wasn't really the time. Father, mother, please tell me. Why and plead, now eager to know. Wen's mother said quietly to her partner that she didn't want to break the news, so her father did. You are part devil, Wen. Her father finally said. That's when Wen's heart stopped for a second. Her eyes went wide and her halo vanished, all life in her dying. She was what? Wen? Her mother and father called out worried. Wen got suddenly regaining her composure. The halo about her head had flickered before staying there. Shining brightly, all life came back to her. What? Wen whispered, looking as if she had seen a ghost. A devil, dear. A half-devil. Her mother said in a small whisper. But how? Wen? Why? Wen had questions, rolling off her tongue in no time. She was so confused as to what her parents had just told her. I understand your questions, dear, but we can't answer them all just yet. Her father stated. But, father, how am I? Wen asked, really wanting to know the answer to this one question that was playing on her mind. I'm a devil, not an angel. I pretended to be in order to stay here. I fell in love with the mother, and she fell in love with me. Of course, it was frowned upon because I was the devil, and she was an angel. But I disguised myself as an angel in order to come up to the heaven and have a life with her. Her father explained. Wen couldn't believe it. For all her life, she had been believing that she was an angel. That's probably why she was outcast to everyone. Did they know? Father, does anyone else know? She asked. No. Her father replied quickly. You are more of an angel from me, dear, but you certainly do have the devil in you. Wen's mother explained. Can I get some air, please? Wen whispered, this is written still taking its time to thinking. Of course. Her parents whispered. Wen took no time to stand up and fly out of the house, not really knowing where she was going, but she knew one thing. She wanted to be out of that house, and she wanted to clear her mind.
Oh my god, I love that. What? Oh my god, that was so good. Oh my... What am I supposed to... Bucko X Devil... Angel... Listen, that was what I'm supposed to call this? And... This is the earliest I've ever, like, started to film a video, because when I just got home from school, I immediately started doing my homework, and right off then, I started cleaning my room, and halfway through cleaning my room, dinner, then I cleaned my room, the rest of my room, and right after that, well, I sat on my phone for like 10 minutes, but right after that, I went to filming videos, so, oh, yes, I'm proud of myself now, oh, with no further ado, I'll see you guys next video, and let me know if you guys want me to read the other parts. Bye!